Oh, it's quite amazing to be here again. Of course, you know what we do when we come here every weekday. It's Sports Today, bringing to you the best of sports and stories around the world, internationally, locally, and of course, globally. And your uncle is always a very good one. Well, today is a big one because I'm not alone in the house this morning. I've got some very big, a big fish. That's what I call her. I'm talking about Mary Onyali or Omagbemi. Mary Onyali or Omagbemi. How you doing? It's quite amazing to have such a big person in the house this morning talking about sport. And of course, I would have to tell you a whole lot she's done for herself, for Nigeria, for sports, for athletes. And of course, she'll be telling us all about that this morning. Good to have you on the program.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Yeah, nice to be here. And of course, she's not alone in the house too. I've got Ike Nwokede. Ike Nwokede, how you doing?
Thank you very much for having me on the show.
Yeah, of course. We've got a whole lot, but today we're going to focus more on Mary Onyali or Omagbemi. First, let's start. What brought you to Anambra State?
Well, when the chicken comes home to roost, it roosts properly. I am a daughter of the soil, Mbaoku precisely. I've been gone on a long sojourn journey, and I have to trace my way back home, and home is here.
Quite amazing. I know Anambra State, the present administration, Governor William Obianọ himself, of course, is so happy that you actually decided to trace your way back home. Well, let me say a big welcome to Ike. Ike, what's been happening?
Well, fine. Of course, our sport is life, like we know. It's a usual thing. A whole lot of things is happening in the state. Yesterday, we saw His Excellency actually receiving at the team that featured at the 9th edition, Team Anambra featured at the 9th edition of the National Sports Festival. It was the best outing for Anambra State. Of course, we are lucky and we are delighted to have a person, of course, a five-time Olympia, two-time bronze medal winner in the All-Africa Games, that being here in the person of our Chief Mary Onyali to be here to grace the occasion. And also, it's a big thing happening in Anambra State, and sport is life. It never stops, and so do we.
All right, like I said, today we're going to be focusing on Mary Onyali and the good, the bad, the victories, and everything she actually has through her career. And let me quickly run through some of the things she's done for herself in her sporting career. She's a former Nigerian sprinter that actually won bronze medal in 4x100 meters relay, and that was in 1992 Olympic Games. And in the 200 meters at the 1996 Olympic Games, she also won the 1994 Commonwealth Games 100 meters title. Well, I can go on and on. And of course, she performed so very well at the All African Games, winning a total of 7 individual medals in the short sprint. Let's quickly come back to you. You know, reading all this out is a great, massive achievement for yourself, for sport, for Nigeria in general. Tell us, how did it all start?
Well, he started at a very tender age of 6. I lived here in Amobia, precisely, with my family, and just playing with neighbors' kids, being active kid, I just picked interest in sport. We used to play around the neighborhood, who is the first to touch the flag and back and football. We're just playing all sports, whatever sports we can come up with in the neighborhood. And I happened to be the best. For some reason, I would compete against the male, the female, and beat them all. And so, you know, some neighbors started picking interest in me and was giving me a pat on the back as a thank you, and some candies and cookies here and there. And that kind of spurred me on. I continued doing sports and taking it a little bit more seriously when I got into secondary school. So from there, scholarship to the U.S. since 1985 to present. I mean, my whole life just changed positively. Of course, you know how it is in Nigeria and Africa, that one, women are not supposed to play sports because we're supposed to be mothers and wives and be in the
house. Okay.
Yeah, that didn't happen with me because Mary Onyali is a very stubborn person. She does what she needs to do to get done. And to be a top-ranked athlete in the world, an Olympian for that matter, you have to have that tendency of stubbornness, but positively.
Right, it's quite amazing, I must confess. Well, I think I will leave Ike. Ike probably has some questions to ask you, Ike.
Definitely. Good to have you on the show once more again.
Thank you.
Yesterday was a homecoming for you back home here in Anambra State. But before then, he thought to this moment, you were at the 19th edition of the National Sports Festival and you offered real motivation to Team Anambra. What do you make of the performance of Team Anambra and the organization getting to the game and also in the aftermath of it?
Well, I've been, like I said before, I've been everywhere but home. So when Sports Commission Chief Oli called on me to ask, since the festival was coming up in Abuja, to ask my assistant. I didn't hesitate because I've been looking for the opportunity to serve my own.
Sure.
And I rose to the occasion. The team came in. I did whatever is needed technically to support the team. Because being centered in Abuja and the festival coming up in Abuja, I was able to get first-hand information as to what is happening. So I feed it back to the commissioner, and we worked really smoothly. The team was very motivated. I have to confess, this is the first time in years, in several festivals, which I've been in quite a bit, that I have seen Team Anambra in a uniform. United. In a uniform format, united, team spirit, I mean, the whole nine yards. The chairman knew exactly what he wanted.
Okay.
And he knew exactly who to help him achieve what he wanted.
Okay.
And he went for it. And I was just fortunate to be there to support him. He couldn't have done it alone.
Yeah.
He has to do it with the 150% support of the governor as well. So without the governor, of course, you know, funding it and all that, we really can't get anything done. So I have to give kudos to His Excellency for his support to the sports commissioner, to the sports commission chairman and the Team Anambra as a whole. And we worked together, we worked in unison, and here is the result, one of the best.
All right. It was quite amazing that you just talked about Tony Oli. I remember just a few weeks ago, we were at Ifite Dunu, where the Academicals had the finals of the under 13 and under 17, which was quite amazing. After a very long time, you know, it actually came. So let's quickly talk about the honor that was bestowed on you yesterday by His Excellency Governor Willie Obiano. Did you see that coming?
I did not see it coming at all. I was blown away. I thought I was just being invited to come and speak to the kids and motivate them and help them chart the best way forward in sports and academics. To my surprise, I'm still speechless. To my surprise, the governor just bestowed this wonderful honor on me after 15 years of being home and looking for an opportunity to pour out the experiences and the talent, what I had in me as far as sports development is concerned. I have so many pet projects scattered all over Nigeria that other states and the nation as a whole have been buying into. And this opportunity of coming home, being given this sports ambassadorial position has finally given me the platform to really exhibit and pour out everything that I have, you know, in me as far as sports development is concerned.
All right, just to let you know that this is quite participatory this morning. It's Sports Hour. We'll talk about everything that has to do with sporting activities around the world. The numbers are on your screen. The very first number is the WhatsApp number. Please don't call that line as much as possible. Just text her. Send your text messages. We'll be here to read it out. The numbers beneath, you can call those numbers. We'll be here to take your calls. Well, you talk about a lot of pet projects. I would really want you to break it down for us, because I know a lot of athletes in Nigeria, in Anambra State, of course, you are the ambassador now, are looking up to you. When you look at what you've achieved in sports, it's quite amazing. It is alarming. And every young athlete would probably want, okay, even if I cannot do what she did, let me try. So right now, break down the pet projects, you know, that you have in store for Anambra State, of course, for the young athletes in Nigeria.
Well, I have several of them, but the one that we're working on right now is the NSDFI, Nigeria Sports Development Fund Incorporated. We have two tiers of it. The boost part of it, which is the basic Olive Opportunity sports training, is catered for primary and secondary school kids. And then the elite part of it is those that have already made the name in the country and representing able to represent Nigeria at the world stage. So the boost part of it is the one I think Anambra I'm bringing to the state to help look for these athletes in the nooks and crannies of the state. If you discover an athlete at a very tender age, like I was discovered at age 6, and encourage them, train them properly, guide them, direct their moves, I see no reason why at age 16, he or she would not be able to find that sport. It doesn't have to be athletics.
Okay.
There's no way that athletes will not be able to find the sport that they are interested in. So I'm here to make that smooth transition to the elite.
All right. Well, we have a beautiful video for you to see. And of course, when we're done with this video, you'll probably tell us what the video is all about. We'll be right back. Okay, quickly tell us.
Yeah, find the words.
You can actually see the reactions on your face.
Okay, that video, every time I see it, it brings back a lot of memory. Just I'm flustering right now. That was at Barcelona 92 Olympics bronze medal celebration after we got third. If you had seen the tape before the celebration, you'll see how difficult it was winning that bronze medal. I was the anchor leg. I got the baton at fifth place, and was just running like a wounded lion. I didn't care who was in front of me. I was just destined to get to the tape. I didn't know I was catching people along the way. Even to the finish, you could see my reaction, waiting to see, looking at the scoreboard, all of us staring at the scoreboard, trying to see if Nigeria was third or not. Because it was a thin line between third or fourth. You know, medal or no medal. So eventually, it seems like forever, standing there looking at the scoreboard. Eventually, we were given the third place, and all the jubilation was all over the place. That video and that picture won the third place award at the Lausanne, at the Mission Center, Lausanne, at the IOC Center in Lausanne, because of the jubilation. You don't have to win.
Okay.
That's what the spirit of Olympism. You don't have to win to celebrate.
That celebration was huge. You were not the only one there. Who were the other members of that team?
It's my, well, let me start from the scratch. It's Beatrice Utondu, an Anambrian.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Amazing.
Faith Idahe from Edo, and Christy Okwara from Imo, and myself.
Wow, quite amazing. When you look at what happened there, you know, like you said, Ibrahim, it brings back a whole lot of memories. Let's come back home. It looks as if in a very long while after you, and of course, I will begin to hear about Blessing Okagbare now, but it has not always been rosy for the Nigerian athletes. What do you think could be responsible for that?
Well, it's been a long way coming. I was dreading this moment. I was dreading this drought in Nigerian sports about 15, 20 years ago. Right before I retired, I get asked by journalists, well, what do you do? What are you going to do to support our sports development when you retire? I keep saying, you guys are not helping us. You guys are not helping us in the sense that we have forgotten the grassroots sports development aspect of things. If I leave, if my generation leaves, because we can't run forever, if we leave for one reason or the other, I don't see anybody replacing us. So you guys need to go back to what brought about the likes of myself on stage. It's sports, grassroots sports development, going back to Interhouse Sports where I was discovered, and having the zona championships, having the local government championship, And having the state championship all through my primary and secondary school days, that's why majority of you don't hear much about me in Anambra, was in Lagos. My primary and secondary school was done in Lagos, and right after my secondary school career, I moved on to the U.S. in 1985. And this is the trend that brought about the glorious days of the mid-80s and mid-90s in Nigeria. Majority of us were shipped out to the U.S. on scholarship. So if Nigeria is yet not ready for the elite aspect of us, let somebody else help you train us. Like they did for myself and the Innocent Ebunikes and the Chidi Imos and the Ezinwa brothers. We were all shipped out, and Team Nigeria was the greatest and the best in that era because majority of us were outside. But it could also be, why not do have a two-pronged approach? Have the homegrown athletes, like the Chioma Ajinwa Chong was homegrown.
Yeah.
She never went to the U.S. like myself, but she was trained here. We can get it done. Have the two-pronged approach, get the American raised ones, and get the Nigerian raised ones, put it together, and Nigeria will be back on the podium. We've been out of the podium since 96. Atlanta 96 was the highest medal haul Nigeria had ever had. And I was fortunate to be a part of that team and was the team captain, at the same time a competitor. So I was able to see that aspect of administration and being a performing athlete. So I guess my grooming days were very long.
Okay, let's get to see this one again because you've got a whole lot of memories. Let's see this. What's really happening here?
This looks like Heritage Bank School Olympics. Yes, I was the ambassador for School Olympics for Heritage Bank that year. It was a fun competition. But what the mistake we make here in having these competitions for youth is when you discover these talents, a lot of talents were discovered here. What do you do with them?
All right.
You don't harness them.
Yeah.
You don't develop them. They just disappear back into the woods. And that's not what sports is all about.
Yeah, I'd like to ask you, I was watching on Sunday, I was watching at the IAF Golden League out there in Rabat. Blessing Okabare seems to be the lady on the spotlight now. She saw off Ivorian Talu.
Mm-hmm.
I saw off skippers off from Belgium. And of course, I took claim the 100 meters and gold medal in that IAF Golden League. But you have numerous pet projects. Tell us about the sports university in Idumoje.
The Sports University in Idumoje is one that Honorable Ned is championing. He is the one that, he needed some technical approach to getting a real sports university.
Okay.
And he made no mistake in getting the likes of myself, Chioma Ajunwa, my late Director General, Mr. Fashikun, to help him with the technical aspect of the program.
Okay.
And so far, so good. It's been a long time coming. It was a project that was very dear to his heart. And we saw the sincerity and the passion in him.
Okay.
And we didn't hesitate to help him.
Let's talk about the Anambra State Sports Development Commission. Under the leadership of Tonioli, you've worked with him. How do you assess and what he has done so far?
I don't mean to toot his horn or put down anybody, but I have been around. I may not have been here, but I've been around and I've seen a lot because I was once the special assistant to the Director General of the defunct National Sports Commission. So I was once in charge of 42 federations.
All right.
So I have seen a lot of commissioners, Anambra commissioners, come and go. Chief Oli seemed to be one that has, a listening ear, because if you feel like you know it all in life, you've definitely arranged yourself for a failure.
Okay.
He listened from the moment he was commissioned. He was given the appointment. I called him. I congratulated him, and I stated my position, the pet projects I have, and helped kind of advised him in the backroom aspect of it as to how to move the sport forward. He listened. He picked it up.
Okay, continue.
Yeah, he picked it up, and here we are. Everything that we have worked, that he has, the plan that he brought in, we kind of sat down and developed it, and look at the results within a short period.
Let's quickly look at this. What's happening here?
Yeah, that was our team, the NSDFI team. We went on a courtesy visit to the vice president. You know, the vice president's office is in charge of sports in Nigeria. So we paid him a courtesy visit, and he received us very well and gave us all necessary support to make sure our project gets a flying start. And that's the director general, the late director general of the NSDFI, Mr. Fashiku on my left, and may his soul rest in peace. He was the brain behind this project.
All right. Well, before we talk about that video, we have a call. Hello, good morning. All right, that was quite amazing. I mean, when you talk about that, let me quickly react to that video.
Too many videos, too many memories. Yes, the first video was the actual full 4x1 race in Barcelona 92. And you could see, if you stop the video at my, when I got the baton, it was at fifth place.
Yeah.
And I was just running. All I was doing was just running. And when we pressed the tape, myself and Perec from France pressed the tape, I was clueless who got it, because she was 10 times taller than myself, long legs. So I thought she had nipped me at the tape, and I was just flustered with emotion, looking at the scoreboard afterwards, almost in tears, because all that could come to my mind right there was, if I lost this third, hard fourth place, Nigeria would kill me. Mm-hmm. That was all that was on my mind, and thank
right.
God.
Let's take this call. Hello, good morning. All right, please, when you do call us as much as possible, move away from your TV set, or better still, turn down the volume a bit. We don't have much time to go, but let me quickly ask this question. I know while you were being conferred as the ambassador of sports in this state, you were talking about the young ones to take the academics seriously. A lot of people feel that sports is life today. Sports has a lot of money. What's the use of going to school? Let's go make money and, you know, become big. But you were really talking about them taking the academics seriously. Let's talk more on that.
You will make the greatest mistake of your life as a sportsman or woman if you put the cart before the horse. That's basically what's thinking about money before your performance. It's my performance, it's my sterling performance that gave me the opportunity to get a scholarship, to go to school. It's my performance that gave me the opportunity to be noticed, to, after my education, now run professionally. There is time for everything. Put it in the right perspective and in the right orders, and you'll be fine. Majority of my teammates or my colleagues during my era, I don't want to mention names, put it backwards.
Okay.
And they never lasted. I stayed on, I think I have the longest stay since 1985 to 2004, 5 consecutive Olympics, because I made sure that I worked on 3 things: discipline, determination, and dedication. These 3 D's are my method of operation. I lived it, I ate it, I slept it. That was why when I was called to come and speak to the kids yesterday on the awards night, that triggered the rest of the what came afterwards with the ambassadorial position, I didn't hesitate, because I want to bridge this experience and everything that I have in me on these children and direct them right, because if you put money first, you're destined to fail. 3 years top or 5 tops years, you're done, because your priorities are warped.
Thank you very much.
All right, I'm Chief Mary Onyali Omagbemi, 5-time Olympian and 2-time Olympic gold bronze medalist. So thank you so immensely for finding time to join us on Sports Today. It's a pleasure having you.
Thank you.
That's the show, of course, overlapping edition of the show. Of course, I thank you so much for being here. From Prince also, and Chief in the house, many thanks for joining us. We'll be back for another edition of Sports Today on ABS TV. Join us again.
Mary Onyali, simply.
Guys, I don't know what is happening to our sport, but whatever it is, it breaks my heart. That's the reason why I left the comfort of my home in Houston, Texas, to come back home after 20 consecutive years of serving our nation and plus. 11 of us, ex-internationals from different sports, we decided to turn Nigeria around. 11 of us came together and we said enough is enough for the drought of sports development in our nation. Because we've been there, done that.